went to a care facility where I have a relative, and they wanted to know why one of their residents from South 14th Street is actually displaced into a care facility because of her senior citizen status, because she can't live in her home and nothing is being done in their eyes. And so I explained to them, as we have throughout the last almost 2 years, that we're working intergovernmentally, if you will, at a snail's pace it may appear, but working diligently. So I just wanted to go on record asking you all to even consider coming to Mount Olive Church to address the concerns of the residents personally. Now, George Connor and others have been very helpful in getting the content together. However, we're at the stage now where it's time for deliverables and the residents aren't seeing that. So to reassure them that this isn't, it wasn't just a feel-good story through the political season, I think it would be a good idea for us to have a unified approach to addressing the residents' concerns firsthand at Mount Olive Church at a time that's amenable to the residents, which is, will be between, as we found out, meaning we as a city, would be best suited for between 5:30 and 8 p.m. During the week. I don't know if that means instead of I'm looking to the solicitor now. I don't know if it means that you go into recess as opposed to adjourning, so that you're not a violation.
A week, sunshine. Well, we can go and hear residents and talk to them. We don't have to have
okay. All right.
So, and it is our top priority. We've said that before. We've made it into every application we can make it in. As you know, some others have not made it easy to do, but we've tried to meet all the requirements to make sure it's in there. We met with the residents couple months ago out there. We actually took forms and let them to for their tax, trying to get some tax relief. So we've been trying to do whatever we can to make sure it continues to be a priority.
Right. And I think at this point, as I think that political season is over, we're boots to the ground, and I think it'll go a long way, not only going a long way, but to show a unified effort as we did in relationship to getting, in Harrisburg in particular, getting sinkholes on a national level recognized as a natural disaster almost over 2 years ago, which it initially was not. As you recall, sinkholes were not noted as natural disasters until we had that convening over at the